Hi, my name is Mike Gunn. I am the production designer on Outlander season 6. And here we are in the Cherokee village. So this was a set that we had, a location, which in the beginning we had nothing here at all. It was nothing but an empty field with a river running past. The river was the main reason that we came here. Plus the kind of clear canvas for us to kind of build our kind of community and the settlement for the Cherokee. This is an episode 4 of season 6. We have a great episode which has Ian and Jamie visiting the Cherokee. And throughout this episode, there's flashbacks as Ian tells Jamie what his past life with the Mohawk was all about and what he experienced. So the basic design challenge for this episode was having flashbacks cutting directly from the Mohawk to the Cherokee, back to the Mohawk, back to the Cherokee. So I very much wanted to try and make the Mohawk very different from the Cherokee, because both kind of First Nation tribes had very kind of, you know, similar look, a kind of similar kind of style, with some nuances and differences in how they acted as a community, how they lived, but visually there was lots of similarities. So my kind of challenge was to try and make them both very different. So I chose the Cherokee to have a very open and expansive setting. I wanted it to be kind of wide and big in scale, and I wanted the Mohawk to be very kind of small and contained, and I set that in the kind of the woods and the forest. So when you cut from one to the other, you could easily distinguish which part of the story you were with. So here we are in the Cherokee. The Cherokee had, they were a tribe that predominantly kind of were agricultural in how they lived. My research showed that they would settle in a place and kind of plant some roots and grow kind of produce and farming, rather than a kind of nomadic tribe that kind of move from one place to the next. So they would settle down. So here we have the Cherokee. This is its main kind of field of its kind of communal space. Now you can see here we have the stick ball game. This is the post in the middle of the village. Upon this stick in the middle of the village, we've got a fish. Now, this was a game that was very similar to lacrosse that they played as a kind of recreational, competitive sport. On this stick, you can see the fish. Now, they would have kind of different symbols for different times of the year. We have kind of depicted the fish. My inspiration for that, obviously, was the river. It was a staple part of their diet. It was something that was very special and very sacred to them. The purpose of this game was for enjoyment and for community, for spirit and for competitive action. And they would have sticks kind of similar to lacrosse. You can see them down here on the ground. And they would catch a ball in this thing, and they would use this stick to try and launch the ball and hit the fish. There would be either pairs or teams playing this game. Center of the community for them to work with. Here we are approaching the council house. This is the main chief's house. This is not a house for dwelling or for accommodation and for living in and sleeping in. This is a house for meeting. The purpose of this house was for the community to come together, to sit together and make decisions about what they were going to do, what they were going to hunt, and who was going to do it. Over here, if we walk to the other end of the settlement, we have what we have built is, we call it the fire pit. It's the main community spot where they would have their feasts and their communal eating, dining, singing, storytelling, all the kind of activities that this community of the Cherokee would have. And there is our director and DOP discussing their shots of the day. This is, as you can see, a kind of communal spot where they would all sit and converse and have fun together. Now, these towers that you can see at the side, there's two of them, and we have another one down the further end of the settlement. These were towers where people could sit up. They would be for a couple of different reasons. Basically lookout towers. So you could have people situated up on the top here, looking down the river to see if anybody's approaching that may either be friends or trade or even maybe a threat to the community. So they're lookout posts. They would also use them to look for shoals of fish. The Cherokee were very skillful in their kind of hunting and trapping of fish. They would build traps, not just with nets, but with kind of pools and rocks and sticks that they would build in the water to kind of attract the fish in their shoals so that they could catch them in numerous numbers rather than individual fish. Very skilled fisher folk. And on the top of the ridge is where you have your settlement of your individual dwellings. Each of the huts we have built here, how many have we built? We've built six huts. We will be putting more huts in Visifex afterwards. And there would probably be about kind of 30 in total, maybe kind of 30 sort of small families consisting of about between six and eight people. And that is the Cherokee.